Hi everyone, this is Thomas Hopp from the product management team at Qlik here, and you haven't heard from me for a while, but today I'm back with something very exciting, which is our new Qlik Anonymous Access offering, which is available now in the cloud, right? So let's have a look into some slides and then I do a demo here as usual at the end. So what I'm going to talk about today is where and why to use the new Qlik Anonymous Access offering, the value, and then how to use this, which is basically the demo part of my presentation. So let's start with the where and why. So there's a couple of examples that I put it together. There is even more than those, and I will focus on the two green marked ones here in my presentation. So if we dive into those examples a bit more in detail, so from a brand trust and transparency perspective, so you can really use Qlik Anonymous Access here because public data builds customer trust by showcasing transparency and accountability, and this can really differentiate a company in a competitive market. So this is where the new Qlik Anonymous Access offering can really help you, right? So the second example I wanted to bring up here is when you are in the data-driven marketing and customer insights business. So then here, once again, so the public data that highlights a company's industry expertise can really attract business partners or customers who see value in their insights. And with the new Anonymous Access offering, you can give them access with ease because there's no lock-in needed, which I'm going to talk about here on the next slide, as well as I show you this, of course, in the demos. From a customer value perspective, so what's the value for you if you decide to go with Qlik Anonymous Access? See, what you're going to get is like an improved user experience because Qlik Anonymous Access simplifies the engagement with the embedded analytics by eliminating the need for user accounts and complex authentication. And what it really means is that you can embed, like you use it with Qlik Embed, charts and Qlik content into your website, and you really give people access to this by not forcing them to log in. So that's what the Anonymous Access solution is all about here. It can expand the reach here, so because you can, by broadening access to external partners, clients and stakeholders, promoting collaboration and knowledge sharing, you really expand the reach of your users. And the increased app value, so the boost the value of the third-party application by embedding analytics, so this is really providing instant insights without extra authentication. Like I said before, no need for them to log in. So this is really going straight to the content, straight to the insights here, while it's public data, because everyone can get access to this, right? So, and the last two, so scalability and flexibility here. So it easily scales to meet changing user demands from you, you know, without the need to manage user accounts. Here, once again, there's no user accounts that you need to manage. It's only about the sessions here, which are then handled by the Anonymous Access offering. And then last but not least on this slide, so this gives you as well as a customer then the competitive advantage because deliver a frictionless user experience that can really drive customer loyalty, and it can then as well differentiate you in the market, right? So that's what this competitive advantage bullet is all about. So after talking about the values and use cases where you can use this, so let's set us up a bit for the demo that I can show you how this kind of works in action. So use cases. So Qlik Anonymous Access supports generating a full link, as well as the ability to use this in the Qlik Embed option. Qlik Embed is most likely, you know, the most commonly used option here, because in the anonymous case, we expect you and customers to use this in the or in your existing websites, embedding content, which I can show you in the demo here, of course. The capabilities are only for consumers, so it's only the consumption use case that we are after here. So you can only consume, and as a result of that, you will not be able as an anonymous user to create any personalized content or creating your own bookmarks or sheets. So it's only the consumption use case here that's important. And the content workflow, it stays basically as is, so you still have to make an app public, or you publish the app to a managed space, and when the app exists or sits in the managed space, you can then enable the anonymous access here, and that setting exists only on apps and managed spaces where you can then make this content publicly available, which you're going to see in the demo. And from a security perspective, so it's important to mention that you're going to get your own dedicated tenant in the anonymous access use case. And there is a security scope added here as well, and the scope takes care of that you can define who should be able to make content public, because not even the tenant admin can do this by default. So you can then, by creating a new custom role, you can then decide who in your tenant should be able to make content publicly available, because when it makes or when it's been made available to the public, then everyone who has access to the link, either the website or the link to the app, can get access to it. That's important to mention here. So, and one more slide before we then go over to the demo. From a monitoring perspective, we have added this into the app analyzer, you know, the well-known tool, one of the monitoring apps that you are using already. So the anonymous access usage here is as well covered in the app analyzer, so you can run this app as well on the tenant that is the anonymous access tenant for you, and that gives you insights into the usage here from an anonymous access perspective. Okay, so but then without further ado, let's go into the demo here. So I switch over to my demo environment. So the first kind of use case I wanted to show you which is where I start on a tenant which is not the anonymous tenant. So I start on my prod demo tenant, and I want to show you how you can distribute an app by using the platform connector in the automation world here from my tenant, which is the non-anonymous one, to my anonymous tenant, right? So what I have here, I have an automation, and this is currently listening to whenever this app, the pharma sales one, gets published, you know, and this is the one that I've already published here, then it will trigger the app distribution. So when I do this, show you first, you know, this is where I'm kind of expecting it to land in my prod apps anonymous on my anonymous tenant here. So when I now publish the app, and I've been doing this before, so you're going to see this. This is the one here. So I select this one, I republish the app, and when this is done, I can switch over here, and then I can show you as well the automation, because now the automation, you know, starts to run. This takes about 15 seconds or 14 to 15 seconds, and then it should be done. So let's give it another 2 or 3, and then when this automation is succeeded here, now it is, you know, I can click on this result. So I could even, you know, this is in the automation that we built it here, a link that I can click on to open it right away. But here in this case, I can now see that this app has been distributed. So this is possible, that you can distribute content from an existing tenant into your new anonymous access tenant, right? So that's one use case. And the other one, or if you want that app now to be made available to the public, so I can show you this here too, and I'll show you this then as well on the embedded scenario. So you have to go to the sharing option, because the app now sits in my managed base. So in here, you get this new option, anyone with the link. And that option is only shown to me because I'm assigned to the scope and the custom security role that I've set up here, which then allows me to do this. So I turn this on. And in this case, I get the link already copied to my clipboard, right? And that means I can go to an incognito window here. I can paste it in. And you see there's this ESC code at the end. That's the one that authenticates the session, basically. And I'll show you this kind of code more in detail in my second part of the demo. But now I can paste it in. And now, as you can see, I'm landing straight in the app without any user login, any user authentication yet that's required, right? So that's the anonymous access kind of thing that kicks in here. So if I go back to my environment, and then the second use case, which includes then the embedded option that I want to show you, is when I go back to my homepage. So now I have this already published app here, which is the embedded anonymous access demo. Same thing, I go to my share menu, and here I have it already turned on, but here I want to show you how this looks like when I go into this cogwheel, the settings. So I have the settings here for the link, the one that I used before, or it's not the same app, but I've been using the full link to the app in my previous demo here. So I can use this one, as well as I can use the embedded option, right? And the embedded option, I can, you know, remember this kind of ID here. So in my Qlik embed example, this is what this data access code is. So there's more content documented on Qlik.dev, because it needs like an OS2 kind of client that you need to set up here. So there's a few kind of things, but generally speaking, it does work the same way as the Qlik embed option today, but it gives you this additional kind of option to use the anonymous access in combination with Qlik embed, right? So what I can do now, I can run this page, or I can run this code. So in this case, you know, and then let me just refresh this, sorry. So there we go. So refreshing this. When this is done, I can run this code here once again. So there you go. And now I can open this in a new tab. So to make it even obvious, so this is now me using the Qlik embed option and then embedding content from the Qlik app here in my Qlik embed example, but using the anonymous access. So no user login, just a few examples here. Once again, this is like how Qlik embed works, but it gives you the additional option to use it now in combination with the anonymous access offering. And last but not least, I wanted to talk about the reset access code kind of bit here, which that gives you the option to reset the access code, and that makes any other link or embedded kind of code here obsolete. So no one can use this anymore. So if you have been, you know, sharing the link to someone who should not have access to the app or the content anymore, you can reset the access code, but keep in mind that then you have to kind of replace all the codes here in your implementations, like either your embedded option or giving people access to the new kind of link from the app, right? So this concludes the demo. It's a pretty exciting feature. Let us know if there's any, or if you have any other questions, don't hesitate to ask, and thanks for listening. Bye for now.